From this, Australia's highest office in the land, under the protection of the law, our fearless leaders have enjoyed a long, rich history of blatant skullduggery to win elections.
He's the only one talking about a death tax.
Death tax?
Death tax.
Stand up to protect Medicare.
The federal government's freeze on Medicare rebates means you'll pay more.
The federal court is scrutinising Chinese language signs used by the Liberal Party.
Political parties are able to do this sort of advertising because the rules around it are really, really grey. As long as there is an authorisation...
Authorised by Liberal Party of Australia.
They're pretty much able to put out what they want.
Authorised by Australian Labor Party, Canberra.
The misinformation has always been dangerous morally and politically, but never dangerous to public health, until now.
Australian Government's COVID-19 Vaccines Adverse Events Report. Click link. Authorised by Craig Kelly.
The TGA this week demanding Craig Kelly's party stop distributing incomplete excerpts it labelled seriously misleading. Kelly, in turn, accusing the TGA of defamation. Labor too is concerned, writing to Google over content like this.
The science is absolutely overwhelming when it comes to treatments like ivermectin and hydroxychloroquine.
Demanding Google explain what steps have been taken to ensure its platforms and advertising capabilities aren't exploited for misinformation, specifically calling out Clive Palmer and Craig Kelly, who says Labor's appeal amounts to a silencing of genuine debate.
Political parties have not wanted to address this in the past because it's benefited them. But since the pandemic and since public health information has become so important, it's something that everybody is starting to look at.
There is hope the laws allowing misinformation in political ads could soon change. Independent MP Zali Steggall set to introduce a new Stop the Lies bill next month.
People have been calling out for truth in advertising for a very, very, very long time. It's a shame that it's taken public health misinformation campaigns to try and get our politicians across that same line.
So, will the COVID Kelly era be enough to finally turn the tide on political misinformation? Authorised by Hamish McDonald for the Project Australia.
Independent MP Zali Steggall joins us. Zali, political propaganda has been around for centuries. How do you actually stop the lies? How does this work?
Well, look, most people in the community are quite shocked to hear that the standards that are applied to commercial advertising don't apply to political advertising. So whilst we have misleading and deceptive legislation to catch advertising that lies about things, we have a free-for-all in political advertising. And that's really dangerous because it absolutely misdirects and misleads voters on people's policies and campaign platform. And I think we need to really be careful because it's a slippery slope and democracy ultimately is impacted. So I do feel strongly we need to stop the lies in political advertising. There has to be some minimum standard of factual basis to support claims made in advertising about candidates to elections.
How do you prove any of this, though, Zali? It's such a grey area to prove what's fact and what's just a sort of interpretation of a fact. And let's be honest, all politicians do it.
Yes, but this is the distinction. So you can make a promise in political advertising and that's fine. The voters will hold you to that promise. What we're talking here about, you cannot make a statement in relation to another candidate that is not based on facts. And we've seen that in Australia, whether it's the Labor Mediscare campaign in 2016 or the death taxes campaign in 2019, the white and purple banners mimicking the AEC. We've seen it and it really does mislead voters. So this legislation I'm introducing is modelled on legislation that's been in effect for some time in South Australia, and it has been effective. So I know everyone is really caught up on the idea of who's the arbiter of truth and, you know, what is a lie, but there is a mechanism. It has proved to work. And so, you know, there really is a way to stop this.
Zali, how much has the internet and social media changed the game for this kind of political advertising in recent years?
Social media has amplified your capacity to mislead. So as soon as a false message is out there, it is You know, you can disseminate that to thousands of people immediately, and unless you have a mechanism to immediately recall it or stop it, the damage is done very fast. So it's really important to have the right legislation in place. At the moment, we have very outdated rules that really don't apply to the content, well, don't apply at all to the content of messaging, but also your only real action is to go to the courts, which is a slow process. So here I'm proposing that we do go to the AEC Commissioner so that you can have prompt action.
If the bill goes through, will Craig Kelly stop texting me?
Well, that's actually another area I'm looking at, because you would not believe, I mean, so many people are writing into my office complaining about this. The difficulty is political messaging is an exception to the spam legislation. So at the moment, there is no legislation to catch that, but it absolutely needs to be on our agenda that people should have an option to unsubscribe or request that it stop.
Well, if you can stop them, I think a lot of Australians would be grateful. Thanks for speaking with us, Sally.
Pleasure.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.